Hi guys, thanks for watching. In this video I will be showing you how to connect these header pins, as we call them, to this Raspberry Pi Zero W in this case. It is not very hard, but if you have never done that, it can look very difficult. These pins are all very close together. Your iron might be a little bit bigger than these pins. Not to worry, we're gonna fix that. It is, yeah, let's start. Let's start by checking the header pins. Check if these are the same length as your Raspberry Pi. They get, if you bought them in a package, they will probably be. You can also buy longer and then just cut them with the pliers and make sure that they're the same length as the Raspberry Pi. Also check if they're all the same length. Sometimes they can slide a bit in this plastic holder and then just put it on your desk like that and that again, so that they're all equal, and then just put it in there. Now we're gonna need to solder them in there. For that I'm going to turn it around and lay it on my desk like this. Now it is somewhat in the correct position, and this is laying here of course because I already did that. Let's see if I can get the solderings in focus. There you go. And this is my previous video. These are some traffic lights I made with the Raspberry Pi. This is just the most thick solder I could find. This probably, if you never soldered before, you probably end up with 1 millimeter solder wire, which is this. This is how I clean my iron. Most of the time I just dip it a couple of times in there. You can also make sure that you're wiping it against this stuff. And this is just, yeah, it looks like steel wool. Let's get that in focus. Actually, it is, looks like copper wire. I don't know exactly what kind of material it is, but well, if I put a flame to it, it burns. But this is I like this stuff, and most solder irons do come with this. It's a little sponge. Don't soak it, wet it a little bit. It works perfectly. Before you start, make sure that your solder iron is hot. It's getting very annoying if it is not hot enough, and you can just check it by applying a little bit of solder to the iron. And if it is smoking and it's taking solder, then it is hot enough. Now I want it to be clean for this video. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to move my camera from there to there to you, so you can actually see close up what I'm doing. There we go. Right, now let's get these pins in there like that and have it laying around just like that. Get my solder iron, cleaning it again. And what I need to do is I need to touch the pad and the pin with my solder iron first like that, and after half a second or so, or a second or so, I can add the solder, and then it would flow so all where it needs to be. There we go. And then we need to release it, of course. That's all you need to do, actually. And sometimes it can look a little bit messy, and sometimes it looks good. Yeah, that depends on how often you have done this before. But before we need to continue, we're going to check if these pins are sitting in nicely, if they're flush to the board. And what I'm going to do, going to the other side, solder the opposite pin. And then I hold my iron a little bit longer this time because the solder wasn't flowed over the entire pad. But don't do that too long. Don't hold your iron there for a couple of seconds, not large number of seconds, because this is plastic and it will melt if you hold it like that too long, and all the pins get in all funny angles and you don't want. Now I'm holding the board with my thumb, and I'm going to, with my index finger and my middle finger, I'm going to push these pins to the board, and I'm going to reflow this solder pad again until I hear this little click. And I'm going to do that with the opposite side. There we go. And that's it for now, for this. Now it is sitting in place correctly, and I'm going to solder all the other pins. There we go. Now that one was a bit nasty, as you could have seen. Now this isn't the easiest job with this type of solder, because the solder wire is actually very thick, and I would prefer, let me get this roll over here. As you can see, this is much thinner. But it doesn't really matter, right? And it takes more length with this solder, but I'm going back to this stuff. Let's see if it is still in focus on the camera. Now, as you see, I'm a bit shaky today, but that's no problem for this project. It is a easy project. Now, if you have never soldered before, I would not just suggest starting with this board. Start with something else. Buy a solder practice kit or something. It's probably the best. Now I'm getting the hang of it, as you can see, and it flows perfectly. Now, this is also nice to see. I don't know if you can see it, but I made a shortcut over there. Short, and that's not what we want. We can solve this in a number of ways, but this one is probably the best. I'm going to clean my solder iron, move it in there, and drag the solder away from the two pins. Now this makes two ugly solderings, so I'm gonna heat both pads again 1 second or so, and then we're done. We can also use a solder sucker. It's a thing with a spring inside, which removes all the solder, but that's not required for this. It's only nice if you want to salvage some components from some existing boards. Now, as you can see, my left hand, and it's probably for you on the right side, is not that steady today. I'm a bit shaky, don't know why. Not that I'm nervous because of recording a video. I've done this 130 times. 130 times. I saw yesterday on YouTube, it told me that I had 130 videos online. It's maybe just because I didn't have any coffee today yet. I'm gonna make it short again. Nope, did not. Clean my iron again. Three more pins, and then we're done. Right, that's done. All the pins are on there. Let's see if I can get it without the shadows and in focus. It's probably a little bit too close to the camera, but okay, it is done. In case you're wondering, if you have a temperature controlled solder iron, mine was set to 370 degrees Celsius. Now it looks a bit messy over here, but we can just scrape that away with our fingernails. Don't use knives, because these lines are very thin, can be cut very easily. But it is done. Now I'm going to do cool projects with this Raspberry Pi Zero. So for now, thanks for watching.